Hey folks, welcome. My name is Garrett Monroe, and I'm excited today to be introducing Module 1. This is Video 1 of Module 1 on our ePortfolio here at Hiram College. I'm speaking to you from our Tech and Trek Center, my office here in the first floor of the library. And the purpose today of our video is to get your footing as a first-year student or your first time experiencing the ePortfolio. This module will help you get your footing and find a path forward in terms of what it can do for you and how to interact with it. So there's 4 points to get out of this video in particular. The most important thing is help and support. Tons and tons of great help and support resources for you here. We give you options and choice in terms of how you want to get support. First and foremost, shoot us an email. Here's our email, techandtrek@hiram.edu. You can also email me directly. Here's my work email. Or, of course, stop by and see us in person in the library. We're here most business days, 9 to 9, and also in the afternoons on the weekends. And we also have the Hiram Tech 101 page on Moodle where you can get tons and tons of support. So don't get too frustrated with whatever you're working on. Come and get some help. It's one of the benefits of being at a small college. So we're also going to talk about the why and what of what we call our connections ePortfolio. And in the next video, you're going to work through creating the ePortfolio itself and sharing it with your seminar course. So the portfolio itself, a little bit of concept on what is a portfolio and then what is an ePortfolio or a digital portfolio. Portfolio has this wonderful, rich history of being something that creative types and artists have used for hundreds and hundreds of years. Here we have a notebook from Leonardo da Vinci. He's sketching out his thoughts, his ideas. So he's using his portfolio here, almost his notebook, as a way of doing thinking, of doing exploration, of reflecting on projects. But oftentimes the word portfolio, that is portable, right, in the word, taking your work with you, is used in terms of a career sense. Taking things you've done, things you've achieved, or things you can do, and showing them off to prospective employers or patrons or what have you. We're actually going to be doing both of those things. We're going to be using the portfolio as a place to enhance our thinking and learning, and as a way to enhance our employability, to enhance our ability to be effective in the economy. Especially in our digital age, more and more folks are looking at not just on a resume, you know, where have you been, what have you done, but actually show the product, show the work, show us the essays, the research, the creative projects, and so forth. We can see all those things live in a digital space, such as an enhanced website. So by way of example, I want to take you on a super brief tour from one of our students, Chelsea Orlando. She graduated just recently. Here's Chelsea's ePortfolio. And in a lot of ways now, you can see her website. And all of you will be creating a website similar to this, but maybe looking quite different. Chelsea was an art and design major, and she's customized her About Me page. All of you will have an About Me page with these 12, 15 grids. And so she shows off aspects of herself, fun facts, where she's from, who she wants to be, her goals. And this is all artwork that was either meaningful to her or work that she's produced herself. We can also see here, she produced this ePortfolio for a specific course, design thinking. And so she's introducing the topic here to the guests, the visitors of the website. I'm going to come back to that in a second and continue our discussion of what is an ePortfolio. Let's fast forward from Leonardo da Vinci to the 21st century here. In a lot of ways, an ePortfolio is really a specialized website. Unlike a normal website, which is always public to anyone, your ePortfolio you have control of, and you can choose who you share it to, who has access to it, and you can change that over time. These have been used at places like Stanford, New York, City University of New York, University of Virginia for decades, actually, to enhance learning. And now they're becoming more popular than ever before. You're going to have control of your ePortfolio even after you graduate from Hiram, so don't worry about that. The most important part is that ePortfolios have been shown to enhance your learning. And it does this through reflection. that is thinking about what you're investigating, what you're learning about after the fact, integration, bringing in multiple different topics, different ideas, different theories into a same space, and social learning. So not just working with a professor or an instructor, but also working with everybody who's on campus, including the peers in your class, in your course, your coaches and so forth. And so the metaphor we have down here is that of a village. So Hiram College, wonderful, small, liberal arts college. And so oftentimes we think about visiting faculty houses. They offer their house as their courses. And this is through our online system, Moodle. And so they invite you in, but that house is totally designed by them. You don't have a lot of way of expressing yourself besides submitting assignments, perhaps, or having a discussion. The ePortfolio is, in fact, your house. This is a space that you own, that you design. You choose what goes in there, how it's presented, and so forth. And you get to choose who comes in and can see your work or have a discussion about your work. And so in this way, we're creating a more integrated, a more holistic community of learners in pursuit of all the wonderful things you're here for, including truth and skill. And so this can be somewhat intimidating as we think about what is the kind of work I put on my ePortfolio? Does it have to be the best work, my most impressive work, the perfect work? And the answer is, of course not. The reason, the kind of work that is most effective on these early ePortfolios is stuff that is emerging. It's used for learning. It's not public. It's a safe space. So I invite you, I encourage you to make mistakes, to try things out, to write down what your thinking is, what your questions are, and invite others within your course, perhaps, or your faculty to respond to that work. Maybe it's a rough draft of an essay. Maybe it's a first try at something or a second draft, and then folks can begin refining and offering feedback in that way. By the end of your 3 or 4 years, however, you'll have a wonderful body of work where you can pick and choose from all this work your best work. And you'll create a separate final ePortfolio, what we call a showcase ePortfolio, where you can say, here is some of my best work. Here's my best research. Here's my presentations. Here's these skills and so forth. And so here's a list of checkpoints at which you'll be engaging with the ePortfolio throughout your first and second, your fall and spring semesters with the ePortfolio. All of this will be available to you in more detail in the courses you're in, but I just give you this timeline as a way of illustrating how you'll be interfacing with it. So we're starting right here with building your About Me page so you can present yourself to your peers, to your instructors, and also learn who they are and what they're all about. So from here, let's go ahead and get started. We're gonna move on to video 2, and we're gonna walk you through creating your ePortfolio and walk you through creating your About Me page and making sure you know how to upload media and share that ePortfolio with your classmates, and of course that you can access your classmates' site as well. I look forward to working with you. I hope to run into you either online or on campus. And once again, the most important part of this video is just knowing where to get help. Shoot us an email if you get lost. Don't be super frustrated. Come to the library and get help, and we will see you soon.